What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video, and in today's video we are going to be discussing day 5 of Detroit Lions training camp. So let's get it started. Welcome everybody to another video. Glad you guys are here. And today we're back with the training camp observations. We're back with the training camp talk. Now, I am doing this video a little bit earlier than I usually do it, so I don't have as many takeaways from day 5. So if there is more news that you guys get, make sure you put it in the comment section below so that everybody can see it. There probably will be a part 2 to this that comes out later tonight, but since I'm leaving very soon, I have to do this one now, give you guys what I have so far, and then later tonight I may come back with you guys with a part 2 and kind of update you on everything that we didn't talk about today. Video, but there is still some very good information. Also, a reaction to Inside the Den, the Detroit Lions YouTube videos, is coming out soon as well. I had to move it around because of copyrighted things. Okay, I did what I had to do. There's some weird music playing over it, and I had to move some stuff around. I'm sorry, I can't get copyrighted, you know, so I had to fix that up. But let's get into today's observations so far. Let's get it started. We have a lot of young guys and a lot of big names that are not participating. Some injuries have came up, which is super unfortunate. But again, keep in mind, guys, the Lions are going to be playing this extremely, extremely safe. Okay, they're going to make sure that everybody is healthy. If anybody has any kind of concerns, they're not going to practice him. I told you guys that they probably wouldn't practice DeAndre Swift today, and that's what we're seeing. DeAndre Swift is not practicing today. So the Detroit Lions are going to be very cautious. There's no reason to rush anybody back, especially these rookies. So they're going to be very cautious with a lot of these guys, but because of that, there are multiple players that had limited to no participation today. So we're going to get into that first. We're going to go through this participation report. So as I mentioned, DeAndre Swift, no practice today. We know yesterday he was dealing with an upper leg injury, and I told you guys, hey, the Lions are probably going to play this safe and not even practice him. Even if it's not that serious, they probably won't practice him. Now, we haven't gotten any updates on what it is, but he is not practicing today, and I'm okay with that. You know, Kerryon missed today on Wednesday. It's good. It's good to let these guys rest, you know, make sure they're safe and healthy for the season, okay? That's what we need. I mean, that's really the most important thing. We need guys to be on the field. We need our playmakers out there. Now, I do like that the Lions have very good depth across the board, but it is great to have your playmakers healthy. So they're going to let a lot of these guys rest up. Unfortunately, Jeff Okuda had to deal with a little bit of an injury today as well. I guess basically tweaked something during practice, and he started off and he tried to kind of push through it, but they ended up just taking him off the field. And again, you know, letting him rest. So again, the Lions are going to be playing everything very safe. You may have played through it if it was a game or something like that, but in this case, they're going to make sure he's healthy, make sure he's good to go for the season. Okay, they're going to try to make sure everybody is healthy for the season. Tomorrow is training camp as well, but Monday is off. So I wouldn't be shocked if Swift didn't practice tomorrow either. They may give him just this huge long weekend to rest, depending on how serious it is. Same thing with Jeffrey Okuda. But I guess with all these injuries, the Detroit Lions went to kind of no pads for today's practice at one point, just to make it a little bit quicker and a little bit of a faster practice. So I guess this maybe wasn't as long as a practice as usual. At least that's what I'm taking away from what I've seen from the observation so far. There still is no Bo Scarborough practicing, which is very unfortunate. He is one of our running backs, but the good thing is we have a lot of depth there, but he has not been practicing. Really don't have an injury update on Bo Scarborough at all. Desmond Trufant was once again held out of team drills, so he was not in team drills. We saw Hunter Bryant, who had to deal with a little bit of an injury during practice as well. He made a nice catch on Jalen Elliott, and then he was taken off because of an injury. So injuries are piling up for a lot of these young guys, new additions, which is super unfortunate. But again, the Detroit Lions are going to be playing everything safe. Speaking of injuries, Kerryon Johnson has been known for his injuries the last couple of years. And in his interview, they asked him about his knee brace, and he basically said, "I'm the knee brace guy. You know, me and the knee brace are one." Okay, that's just how it goes. I like it. You know, Kerryon Johnson finding some humor in it. He also said Blazers in 6, so I don't know how y'all feel about that one. I know there's some Lakers fans. I know there's some LeBron fans, and they're like, "Oh snap, I don't want to hear that." They don't like Kerryon just because he said that, I bet. Well, hey, no Damian Lillard, that's going to be really tough. Okay, we're getting off topic. We're talking about NBA at this point. Kerryon Johnson also said he doesn't want people to record him during his workouts because a lot of people don't think he's putting in work during the offseason, which he is, by the way, just because he isn't recording it. Well, Kerryon Johnson said, "Hey, the reason I don't have these videos up because I don't want to pay people to record me." Now, he wouldn't have to necessarily, depending on how he's doing it, but some people, you know, probably, you know, they probably do pay people to record him. He's saying, "I love my money too much." Kerryon, honestly, I feel you there, my guy. I can't really fault you for that at all. I'm not even mad that you don't put out workouts. Not every player is going to put out workouts, okay? It's okay. I know you're putting in work during offseason. You're an NFL player. I'm sure you are. I'm not worried about it at all. It is cool to see videos, without a doubt. I love watching videos of the players working out, but hey, it is what it is, and I respect that completely, man. Hey, keep your money, man. You earn that money, keep the money. Now, because of all these injuries and all these players not participating, our two top cornerbacks today were Daryl Roberts and Amani, which is good to see Daryl Roberts get some reps in there as a top cornerback, because I think he needs that just in case something happens during the season. And Amani continues to get first team reps reps, and Amani has looked great. We talked about yesterday's interception over Kenny Golladay. He has looked really, really good up to this point. Amani is making a strong case to be a starter to begin the season, and again, I would have no problem with it. Now, going to the offensive side of the ball, Justin Coleman talked about Jamal Agnew, saying that he was very impressed by Jamal Agnew's transition from defensive back to wide receiver for the Detroit Lions offense. Defensive backs are the best playmakers on the team. Okay, I see you, Justin Coleman. And now when Justin Coleman was asked, hey, would you ever think about trying to go to offense? Which I don't think we want him on offense, but would you ever try that? Justin Coleman said, no, I like it over here on the dark side. You know what, Justin Coleman, we like you there too, man. We love you in the slot. So keep doing your thing at the nickel position, man. Continue to get better. Probably been some good battles there with Jamal Agnew and guys like Justin Coleman and things like that. Speaking of another good battle, Taylor Decker versus Trey Flowers. This is something that we've been keeping our eye on. It's very, very talented. Taylor Decker has held up his own this offseason so far, and we know he's trying to get paid this season, right? This is his last year on his deal. He wants to get paid by the Detroit Lions. He wants that contract extension. He's been off to a very fast start, and Trey Flowers recognized it today, saying that he was impressed by Taylor Decker's feet. His footwork is great, and yeah, I like it. You know, Taylor Decker, from what we've seen, has done really, really well day in and day out against Trey Flowers, and that's really good for Flowers. It'll make him get better, make him add pass rush moves to his arsenal. And then another battle that we're hearing of, this one is actually on Twitter, J-Rod Curse brought up his battle with guys like TJ Hockenson. Now, I've told you guys J-Rod Curse could be that X factor defensively, obviously once he's back from his suspension for the first three games. But J-Rod Curse is that guy that can line up at slot, which is the most place he actually lined up last season for the Minnesota Vikings. But he can line up literally everywhere in the defense, cornerback, slot, linebacker, safety. You can put him anywhere and he'll be fine. That's what's great for the Detroit Lions defense, especially in passing downs. They can put J-Rod Curse out there. He's not a liability in the tackling game, and he can cover guys like TJ Hockenson, which we need. So he's talked about how great the battles have been there, and yes, I love it, man. It looks like everybody's kind of complimenting each other. I'm telling you guys, the bond is great. The team chemistry is vibing. This is what we want to hear. This is how the Lions are going to win football games next season. So I'm excited to see how this season goes, of course, and I probably will have takeaways come out a little bit later. So stay tuned for those for a part two, but this is all I can do for now. This is what I have so far. Let me know your thoughts, comments below. Thank you for watching, and I'm out.